guys, Moshe the Electric Israeli is here and thank you for joining. The other day I posted a video about my experience fixing a cracked windshield on my Tesla Model 3. I'm going to put the link right above so you can watch this. It's very good informative video. And this Model Y I'm driving right now, I'm supposed to get the Tesla mobile service to come and change my left rear lamp because it has condensation and some water and some plastic cover in by the door, at the door hinge, I'll show you. We'll see if they come. I keep getting emails from them that the part is pending. So I won't be surprised if they're going to postpone the appointment. My appointment for the Tesla Model 3 windshield crack was postponed 3 times and I had to wait a month and a half to get that part. The point of this, what I'm telling you is, I'm not making this video or video like this to discouraging you from getting a Tesla. I am exactly the opposite. My whole motto is change the world one electric car at a time. Absolutely, it's a great car and all that. So you know, FYI, so you know, that even though Tesla cars, and for that matter, electric cars, need little or no traditional maintenance, like oil changes and all that smog and all that stuff, and you don't even have to have an inspection for that car, you don't have to have that sticker of inspection. That's great. But specifically for Tesla cars, anything having to do with parts, well, get ready to wait for a long time. I have to be honest with you. Get ready to wait for a long time. Sometime a month, sometime 2 months, or even more. Any paint job that you need scratches or whatever, Tesla will refer you to a certified body shop. So Tesla will not do it for you, which is actually good because the body shops are very good at it. So I did, I had some scratches on my Model 3 and Tesla referred me to a local body shop, which I know, and they did a great job. But anything having to do with panels, windshields, lamps, anything that is parts, get ready to wait. It's going to take a long time. And the reason is, there's not too much Tesla aftermarket parts that you can get. So anything having to do with panels, lamps, you know, for the tail lights or front, bumpers, apparently windshields, I experienced it myself, it is the parts that come from Tesla. So even if, even though Safelite was happy to change my windshield, they told me they have to order that part from Tesla itself. So it takes time. Like I can tell you for sure that tires, rims, there's plenty of aftermarket for that. Obviously, floor mats and things like that. So a lot of accessories, tires and rims you can easily find. I bought so many tires and the rims from Tire Rack, so you can find them. They are available. They're not exactly what Tesla uses, but great, close enough. There is a wild west of those items. You can find them easy peasy. But anything else that having to do with the body of the car, okay, good luck waiting. Okay, so you know that if that happens, which you know happens to everybody, it's gonna take a while. Now the service itself, once you get the appointment, once you get the part and once you get the appointment, then you're good. The guys are great, they're doing a great job. One last thing, the prices are ginormous. Watch my video. I mean, they charged me for the replacing of the windshield over $1,000. That's a $400-$500 max thing in a car size like the Tesla Model 3. So you know, things like this add on, you know, they add up and they cost a lot. So I can tell you to be careful, but sometimes it's not gonna be your fault. Okay, you can drive on the highway and get hit by a pebble, and there you go. So, FYI, so you know all these things. Okay, guys, I think you got the point. Thank you for watching. If you have specific questions, let me know in the comments below, and I'll be happy to answer. See you tomorrow.